Today, we are going to see broadening access to health to poor and vulnerable sections of the society in India. Health in India is a state subject. Although the central government shares a significant part in establishing healthcare infrastructure, each of the Indian states determines their priorities in healthcare. India's 12th plan document promises to build upon the initiatives to expand the reach and coverage of healthcare to achieve the long-term objective of universal healthcare. The ultimate goal of universal healthcare is to ensure that everyone, everywhere, should have access to essential healthcare services without facing financial hardship. World Health Organization has identified four key financing strategies to achieve universal healthcare. The first is increasing the taxation efficiency. Second one is to increase government budgets for health. And third one is to innovation in financing for health. And the last one is to increase developmental assistance for health. Unfortunately, all of these measures fall beyond the control of ministries of health and less likely to be influenced by their efforts alone. An analysis of South Asian countries reported that access to basic care varied substantially within and across each country. In India, financial risk protection was only 17.9% and prevention and treatment coverage for selected health conditions was 83.5%. The study also raised equity concerns, highlighting that access to care for maternal and child health services was higher among rich as compared to poor mothers. To address the health inequalities and improve health outcomes, an architectural correction in public healthcare system was made by Ministries of Health and Family Welfare through National Health Mission. This is to strengthen both rural and urban public health infrastructure, human resource capacity and service delivery. However, in spite of all the efforts, the total health expenditure in India remained at 4.7% of GDP in 2014. The contribution of public health care expenditure also remained stagnant at 30%, which is one of the lowest among low and middle income countries. To address the policy changes and fill the critical gaps in achieving UHC, the National Health Policy Mission Health Policy in 2017 has been approved by the Union Cabinet. To translate its vision into a reality, Government of India approved Ayushman Bharat National Health Protection Mission. The press note of Ayushman Bharat Mission suggests that the scheme is expected to have major impact on reduction of OOP expenditures on ground, out-of-pocket expenditure. Increased benefit cover to nearly 40% of the population, poorest and vulnerable societies. Covering almost all secondary and many tertiary hospitations except a negative list and coverage of 5 lakh for each family. So these are the benefits covered through Ayushman Bharat. But the problem is that not only hospitalization but also outpatient care leads to impoverishment of households. For families living on daily wages, hospitalization probably is the last resort in an illness episode, as it not only leads to a catastrophic expenses but also to loss of wages of more than one earning member of the family. In addition, a healthcare consultation unleashes additional demands for help, such as care for comorbidities and patient support services, and many of these services are not covered as part of health insurance. Any health scheme favoring hospitalization alone over comprehensive outpatient care and coverage may not be an appropriate product for health needs of the society. For example, Ayushman Bharat National Health Protection Mission may consider providing outpatient care, medicine and diagnostic charges, travel allowance, and most importantly, wage loss compensation as essential ingredients of the benefit package and not just hospitalization expenses. The benefit package may also be expanded to take care of needs of special groups such as elderly who are on long-term medical support through outpatient services, support for children with special needs, people requiring long-term rehabilitation, and victims of road traffic accidents. Global evidence suggests that the tax-based financing is the most progressive form of financing mechanism to fund healthcare services, followed by social health insurance, whereas out-of-pocket expenditures are most regressive. However, if government decided to go for insurance-driven financing mechanism for healthcare services because of the strategic reasons such as developing healthcare market or utilizing strength of existing private sector, a cautious approach is warranted to prevent regulatory capture. Also, to have synergy between Ayushman Bharat and health and wellness centers as a desirable goal, as this would ensure complementary between secondary and tertiary care services covered through this scheme. With the comprehensive primary care of health and wellness centers and would prevent a demand-side moral hazard and healthcare cost escalation. Thank you.